Good afternoon, everybody, and happy Friday. This is Miss Louisa, and are you ready to get your STEM on today? So today we are going to be making fizzing blocks. What you will need is 1 cup baking soda, 1 teaspoon unflavored gelatin, food coloring of your choice, 1/4 cup of water, an ice cube tray, some vinegar for later, and a bowl to mix your dry materials in. So I have 1 cup of baking soda in here, so I'm going to add my glycerin, and I'm going to mix until they are both incorporated equally. You might have some lumps in the baking soda. That is perfectly normal. So once this is mixed up, we can set that aside. And now this is the fun part where we get to add the colors. So if you're just doing 1 color, that's simple enough. You have 1 container, 1 color, and 1/4 cup of water. When you want to start doing multiple colors, that's when you have a little bit of math. So each cup needs the same amount of water. So there are 12 teaspoons of water in 1/4 cup. So to get, so if I, for 3 colors, to get the amount of water I need, I divide 12 by 3. So I know I need 4 teaspoons of water. So if I were to have 4, I would need to divide 12 by 4. And I would know I would need 3 teaspoons of water in each. So I'm going to use my teaspoon measure to measure out 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. There we go. So now, if you want lighter colors, put in a couple drops. But start off with fewer, and then you can add more. So I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4 drops of blue. It's a darker color. I'm going to do 4 drops of green. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I am going to do 6 drops of yellow because it is a lighter color. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are my colors. Now, this is a fun part. We are going to divide the baking soda glycerin mixture. I'm using 1 tablespoon, so I'm going to do 1 tablespoon with the blue, 1 tablespoon with the green, 1 in the yellow, and I'm going to keep doing that until they all have gotten their allotment. And my curious cat wants to know what I'm doing and if she can eat it. Because it is baking soda, I would advise against letting your animals, if you have any, partake. Freya, shoo. All right, there we go. Now, it's going to mix them until all the baking soda is more or less blended. Of course, I'm using what I have handy, a regular spoon or a craft stick might work better. So, once it's that like there, I'm gonna do one color at a time. So let's see, I'm gonna do yellows on this side. And pouring them in, packing them down. And yeah, there you go. Let's see, I'll do it. So now, once you've done this here, just continue with your other colors. And if you want to mix them in a single ice cube, that's great. That's awesome. And yeah, so there's yellow. And I'm going to do my others colors next. And yeah. All right, so now that I have all my colors done and in, the next step is to put this in your freezer for several hours or overnight. And next, when you get it out, you'll get a tray or a pan, flip this over. So each little, your cubes come out, and that's when the vinegar comes into play, and you'll pour a little bit of that over the cubes and get them fizzing. So I hope you enjoy this STEM activity, and see you next time. And here is the moment of reckoning. My cubes were in the freezer for 3 hours. And as you can see, I picked out 9. So I have more for another time. I have here some vinegar, and I am going to pour some on. And watch the foaming commence. And it's a little bit of powder tip that I brushed in the corner. So there you go. Be sure to share your results if you do this to our Facebook page.